fifth scale Chevy Impala with 454 engine and all kinds of extra goodies in the box. So let's take a look and see what we're going to have when you get yours. First, the absolute giant Impala body and interior. That is a big size car. Back in the day, these things were ginormous. Check out the interior. Now, this is all molded in a deep red, which should make painting easier if we paint it at all. So let's take a look. We got nice detail on the chassis. On camera, the red looks a little off. In person, it is a dark red, a pretty vibrant red, actually. So I'm going to see what it looks like under a clear coat. And we might be able to build this without doing a whole lot of paint work, at least on the body. We're going to have to paint the chassis and everything else, but we'll get the rest of it done without paint if I can. If not, I'll have to paint the body. So let's take a look at some of the other styrene in the box. We got full exhausts. Now, this is a stock vehicle used by a fire department or a squad car, so of course it's going to have the giant factory exhaust on it. And we'll see some other options in the box. We got little resonators there, differential. All big parts on a big car like this. We got suspension detail. Looks awesome. On this one, we've got our front bench seat, which makes perfect sense. We've got a battery. We've got minimal flash on stuff, but you can see some of it. We got the hood there with optional cutout to make this a performance model. We got our front clip there. We've got a rear window resizer there if you want to chop it down. We got some lake pipes there. Radiator. We got a beautiful giant dashboard. All flat in there. Shouldn't be too difficult to detail. These General Motors dashboards, steering wheel, weren't all that exciting back in the day. They were very utilitarian, even in the nicer cars. We got a chain steering wheel here if you want to go for the lowrider version. We got the firewall there with marginal detail, but it's still good. We got wire, or that's the radiator support, I'm sorry. We got wires and stem whatnot and boxes on there. We got springs, shocks. Here's the firewall right there with good detail. Heater box, wiper motor. We got a master cylinder there impressed in. We've got our manifolds, our heads, and our intake to the 454. We've got the transmission and engine halves on there, water pump, distributors all included, oil pan and filter. We got a belt and pulley system. I don't know what that is. Maybe that's the back of a seat. And we've got other small vehicle trim pieces. Let's switch to the other side of the table because we're not done. We're not even close. We got a nice parts bag with clear parts in there. We'll leave that so I don't scratch them. We have the transparent red parts for the lights on top and the vehicle itself. We've got a set of four Goodyear polyglass tires. Nice tread design. Black wall on both sides, which makes perfect sense for a utility vehicle. We've got one, two, three, four chrome trees coming at you. Check that out. Beautiful chroming on that. Nice high quality plastic for the stock wheels. We've got all kinds of option parts on here. Wheel trim, intake, check that out. Those stacks there. We got more wheel trim. We got a full set of wheels there that are molded open. Nice chrome headers on there. On this tree, we've got more fire chief parts. Be careful, don't break these. These are the legs to your light bar right there. We've got side lights. We got fire extinguisher, mirror, marker light. We got the microphone to the CB radio. Here we've got our beautiful grill. We've got another set of wire wheels and another set of wheels on there. We got the rear bumper. We got the custom grill on it. We've got chrome valve covers, fan, air cleaner, carburation and intake systems, everything you could think of, and the rear bumper there, and there's that optional intake, looks gorgeous as well. And one more thing in the box, the fire chief and squad car decals. You have enough to do either a squad car or a fire chief, whatever you choose. That's all in the box for you, including striping. Excellent looking, even some stripes for the custom version, it looks like. Some fancied up stuff, and the chief emblem. So that is everything that's in the box. I'm going to begin building, and we'll be right back. there's a ton of extra parts in the kit, but if you want to build the fire chief, you don't have a lot of stuff to worry about. We've got that 454 assembled. I'm going to paint it up like it is. The manual says use the chrome valve cover, so we'll put it on there, dress it up a little bit. Maybe the fire chief ordered a special unit. Maybe that 454 came with chrome valve covers. You know, we can always imagine whatever we like. We'll put the carburetor on there and the air cleaner. We'll make it look a little fancier under the hood. He's got the pursuit mode car, so that 454 comes out nice. Goes together very easily. In the red plastic, it can be a little difficult to see, but we got the manifolds on there. I like doing the hand painting of the starter and the manifolds and the distributor and all that, so that's why I glue everything on as one piece, and then it won't break off either. The seats were super complicated. You had to take that square piece of plastic, glue it to the back, and our front bench seat is all set to go. The only part we need here is the radiator hose on this, so I cut off that tree. These are if you want to change the height on the vehicle. Those would be the front kingpins you'd use for the options. On the belt and pulley system, there is this neat little bracket to mount on there, so make sure you glue that in place, and then just glue your fan in place. I'll put the chrome alternator on later, and we'll paint this all up in black, so I left it on its little tree so we can clip it onto the stand. The exhaust, of course, is all one piece. We'll get it painted up. I think when I show you the chassis here, I did want to get this all painted up together because this can be kind of hard to line up with the mount and the sway bar and everything in the back. So I wanted to make sure I got it glued in there solid. I had to pull it off and remeasure the height to make sure that I had the right height with the springs back there and everything. So I had to do that a couple times just to make sure it lined up right. I would recommend shaving these two trailing arms down so that they fit into here better with your glue, and then you'll be able to line that up. Make sure you've got the equidistant and that it's the same height on both sides, so you don't have it sitting as a three-leg motion when it's going down the street, and then that sway link goes across the back and I've got the shocks on. We'll paint this all a GM factory black. We'll just leave it the way it is, nice and plain Jane. We'll give it a little dry brushing, give some details to it. The front suspension is the same way. You can see the way those kingpins go on, the stock ones are halfway up. They can be posed as a steering kingpin, so feel free to do that with them if you choose. Otherwise, the springs and everything just mount in, and you are set to go without issue on that. And then I mounted the radiator on the chassis, lined it up. There is on the body, let's change that out. On the body, when you install it, will be these grooves that will go into that radiator mount in the front to line up the front of the body. The body needs no work except I remove that X pattern bracing and the roof bracing. Since it's in my hands now, I won't be crushing it, but that's placed in there. The hood goes on nicely. The front grill isn't on, so the hood can fall through still. But also, when you're cleaning up the body, do not cut off these little pins. That will help the hood retain its shape when it sits on the car, and it won't fall backwards. I've shown you that on some NASCAR kits as well. So that's all set. But we were talking about the exhaust. It might be pretty difficult for me now to snake the exhaust through since I decided to glue it all together now. All I'll have to do is cut it about right there and super glue it back together after it's painted. It will come out to the resonators on either side. The resonators mount up. So we'll glue the resonators in with super glue once they're painted. We'll put this exhaust in, we'll pin the exhaust in place, then we'll be able to line up this last little piece. We'll slide it underneath that axle, super glue it in place. You'll never know the difference. It won't show up at all. The dashboard and the steering wheel aren't going to need anything fancy except for primer and paint. When I paint this, I'm going to have to primer everything but the body and this rear pan here. That we're going to leave to paint up. But the firewall I'll be priming, the chassis, the exhaust, the interior, especially the interior tub. I don't want any of that red to show through, so I'm going to cover everything with black primer first, then get into our color coats, and I'll see you over there. Thank you. Let's take a look at everything I've gotten up to so far at this point before I'm going to start doing some final assemblies, some final detailing. Check out that engine. That looks awesome. I did go with the chrome valve covers, the breather, the carburetor, the alternator. He's the fire chief. Our local fire chief has a pretty dressed out truck. So who knows? Maybe he ordered it with a little extra or he put it on himself. My dad worked for the highway department. He used to dress up his dump truck even though he had to pay for it all himself. That looks awesome. And that's, I'm not going to go worrying about factory accuracy. I love the look of that engine that way. And that's how she's going to drop in, relatively new, shiny. They're always taking pretty good care of their cars. Front bumper and grill is all done, and that looks outstanding. Got the red lenses. The Mod Podge on the lights didn't seem to make any difference whatsoever, so I just left it alone, but that's how that'll look. We've got our orange turn signals, and I did put a little bit of orange on the side. Barely noticeable for the side marker lights on the bumper that they show on the box. But that looks great. That grill's going to look beautiful using my black paint and Q-tip. The taillights just push right into the back, and then I glued them in position, and we are all set. This will all be future floor polished to really bring that shiny chrome out. You saw me detail the hood. Very easy to do with the silver marker. Nice looking. This all needs clear coats. Nothing will be clear coated until the whole car is together. Then I will go over the whole body decals and everything with some future to shine it all up. Got the exhaust in just like I thought. I had to cut it to fit it underneath, but see where it is? You can't even tell it's been cut and put in place. The exhaust looks great. That's ready to mount up. We've got our drive shaft buried underneath the exhaust, so make sure you get that in first. And then our engine will be going into the chassis, and we are all set. All I did underneath the hood was accent the battery that's glued into place. That's ready to go. The little bit of dry brushing really brings it out. I took some testers, red acrylic paint, painted up the wheels so that I only had center caps left. Those need one more coat of paint all the way around. I hand painted those. I want them to look like red steelies with a chrome center, which is what it looks like on the box and the box side art. You've got the red wheels with the little chrome center. So that's what I wanted to imitate with the parts included in the kit, and it was easy enough to do. I just need another coat of paint on that, and that will be all dried up. Working on the body, got the trim on. If you have a long piece of trim and you're a little bit scared about using a silver pen on it, just run a piece of masking tape along the bottom and then put your marker at an angle and run it down, and there you go, your trim is all done. The fire chief emblem will go right over it. We can see on the box, the fire chief emblem goes right over the trim, goes right over it. There's even a bump there for it, so that's the way they have it. I'm completely cool with that. They just ordered a fancy red Impala and stuck their magnetic door logos. I took two small drill bits, drilled one hole for the side mirror because it has a large mounting lug, and one hole for the spotlight that goes on the front. So I wanted those drilled out so that those would hold solidly when I glue them into place. Those are set. Otherwise, there is no mirror on this side, and all we have is trim. After the clear coat is all done, I'll go in with a silver gel pen or a silver pencil and whoop, and I'll rub on the Impala logos and the 454 logos so that they stand out a little bit. But otherwise, all the trim on the body is done. That's ready to go. We are all set. That just needs some clear coating and very final trim work with the two. Now, talking about these pens as well, I've got the dashboard. This has been painted with craft paint. You can see it's getting very nice and flat. You can either take a very sharp pencil and gently rub it to bring out detail, and you can do trim with a silver gel pen. It doesn't matter the brand, but it's literally just a silver gel pen, guys. You can Google it. And we will draw on our silver trim, use the silver pencil to gently rub on there, make sure it's very sharp, gently rub on there and get our detail off on the dash. I've shown that in some other videos, like the Bandag Bandit video. So that's a nice basic work dashboard that will go into the tan interior. The interior is all set, very basic silver trim on the handles. The seats are glued in place. That's it for the interior. I'm not getting any more fancy than that on a nice workhorse. He's got a little bit of fancier trim, but the interior is more utility. I have to still assemble the light bar, the lenses, glue the radio onto the dashboard so that it'll fit, and whatnot, the little lenses on the part for the flasher lights all go on top. That'll be using super glue to put together, and then it'll get coated with Future in case I get any cloudiness on the chrome from the super glue. So it's all basic detail now. I will finish detailing that dashboard and then give the gauges a coat of Future so they shine up just a little bit. We will start putting the engine into the chassis. We will get the interior mounted to the bottom of the body. You can see it's got two huge pins. You can't get that wrong, that line up with those holes there. We will get the firewall attached to the front of the interior at that point. Then we will be able to put our front bumper on once our body's on, put our rear bumper on, put our rear trim on. I will come back before decals right when I get it all together. Major assembly is done. No real issues to speak of. The hood lines up. I only had one minor gap left over when I put the front bumper and grille assembly on. I wanted to make sure, first and foremost, that the headlights were lined up with the side and that the hood fit correctly. So I ended up with a little bit of gap on that front bumper, but on the other side, it's really nice. It's a little smaller, so it looks great. So she is ready to go. I've got the mirror on. I've got the spotlight in there where I drilled it out. I even put the little baby antenna on the trunk lid. All I need to do now, you can see it looks great together. I like those red wheels with the chrome centers. It seems to sit right. It sits on all four, which is always important. That tan interior looks great through the big glass. Looks very official. The rear bumper looks nice. We got the tail lights on that mounted straight across there. And on the bottom, that trim piece glues to the back of the bumper, and that mounts on and looks nice, and the exhaust is just barely peeking through. So what I have left to do is to apply the decals and then the light bar. The light bar I will attach with Mod Podge just so I don't cloud anything on the roof or screw it up with super glue. Can look a little crusty, so I will just take little dips of my Mod Podge gloss and dab it on the four corners of the light and set that on the roof. Then I'll apply a coat of Future floor polish. This is what it's still called from the old days. Now it's called Pledge Floor Shine. And I will brush that on the car from front to back, top to bottom. Everything but the tires themselves will get coated with it, and we will be all done. You can see the decals that I've picked out. The fire chief, obviously, the fire department, the cool bumper sticker on the back, the American flags for the pillars here, the Michigan plates, the chief and the 52 district emblems on that. Those will look nice, and I'll decide where to put those on the car when I do my final assembly. When we come back, this will be on the turntable. The funky red fire chief in 125th scale 1970 Chevy Impala by AMT is all done, and I enjoyed the build. I went with another non-painted surface. Now in the video, the red might look a little off. I'm using a lot of studio lights. You can see the shadows casted and everything, so it might be a little bright on that red. In person, it does look like red painted plastic. It is a very vibrant red. It looks darker when you have bare plastic, but once I applied two coats of Future to it, and that's all I did was brush two coats of Future floor polish over the top, it really turned it into a much stronger red, much more attractive. I did enjoy the build. I had to paint those wheels to get the hubcap look on them, or you could fancy it up. You can do it as a squad car. You can customize the thing. Check out all the decals that are left over. You can build it as a customized lowrider. Remember that chain steering wheel, the lake pipes, all the other cool stuff in the kit. Or you can go like me and build it just like the box to match up with my Monaco squad car and my New York police van I built. These are all service municipal vehicles from AMT and MPC, and they come out awesome. I thank Round 2 for sending this kit. These are out right now, or they should be when the video is produced, so I will link you in the description where you can order yours. You can pick it up. You can go ahead and paint it up if you want. You can do just the plastic. As you see, just the plastic looks great with some clear coating on it. No issues at all. The only fit thing was that small gap on the bumper I showed you. And on the box top, I noticed that the light bar is supposed to be a rail-mounted light bar on the drip rails. But the bar is actually a little too narrow when I assemble it. Per the directions, there's actual large detents on the bottom for the rail mounting bars, and I didn't want to press down. I probably could have pressed down and got it to snap over the sides and glued it into place, but I didn't want to break it after all the work I had put into it and delay getting my video done. So I just gently glued it on the roof. It looks fine as a roof-mounted bar, and there are plenty of vehicles out there with roof-mounted bars, so it doesn't affect the look of the vehicle, and only specific people would say, oh, that's supposed to be mounted to the drip rails. It's sitting a little high. On here, it looks absolutely fine. I future coated the chrome once I got done because it did get a little cloudy from the super glue that I used to attach all the five lights across the top, and all that cloudiness went right away. That's another thing of the miracle fluid future. The CB radio and everything is inside the car, the fire extinguishers on the passenger seat. The fire chief is ready to go and inspect the fire when it's all over. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build for you. Build your kits the way you want. If you don't want to paint the plastic, clear coat it. Have a good time with it. It still makes a gorgeous model either way. We will see you at the next review.